ISIS Arena in the Rothman Center on the campus of FDU. WCTV is proud to present the 63rd Oscar F. Thompson Memorial Bergen County Jamboree. This is the fourth game we're doing tonight. It pits Don Bosco Press versus Ridgewood. John?
Well, you know, Larry, this is the Status Arena. But we're fine.
What do I call it?
The Status Arena.
Oh, that's Stratus.
Stratus.
Well, after 8 hours, I'm a little
I know. But let's start with the Maroons, the Ridgewood, under Mike Troy. They've lost 6 games, but this team plays everybody. The losses were, they were against Kennedy, St. Joseph, Ramsey, Ramapo, Hackensack, and Ramapo. He runs, he's got great shooters, and then of course you have Don Bosco. And Kevin DeVario just won his 500th game as a coach. This is a team that's got 3 outstanding players. And Larry, what they have here, they lost 3 games. Ramney, everybody loses to Ramney. Then they lost to Bergen Catholic and St. Joe's. So key players are Konupka, Owen McGlashan, and Kyle Moreira. This should be a great game.
And they are the defending Bergen County champs. They won last year. They had one of the greatest years of Bergen County basketball, winning division, winning the Jamboree, the county, winning the states, and getting into the tournament of champions.
They lost there.
But they had a great season. They're getting back here. If they win, they get to the semifinals again. Kevin DeVario does a great game. Ridgewood has an outstanding team. They're building a great program over there, John. So, and they are a hard team.
These are the players you got to watch. Devin Johnson, Matt Fabieri, Matt DeFeo, and David Usher. These are the guys that are going to score.
So now we're getting ready to turn this over to the voice of the Jamboree, the one, the only, Joe Hausman.
Number 2, Ben Garrity. Number 2. your starting lineup for the Maroon of Richmond High School.
Final game, we do have a pretty good crowd here.
Nice crowd. The two sides, not that much, but behind us.
In back of us, in front of us.
Front of us. Got a little bell.
Got a couple of bells ringing here. Got a couple of bells ringing here.
I'm waiting for the horses to come in. Here they come.
Well, referees are ready. Brian Carr's ready. You tweeting out there, Brian? Is he tweeting everything?
Brian Carr.
Oh, there it is, BB. Are you tweeting? Yeah, Brian is tweeting.
We're going to do...
We are ready. Konopko will jump against Miller. There's Bobby. Where's Bobby? There's Bobby. Wave, Bobby.
There's Bobby.
Wave. There you go. Good. That's it. Sharma has. And we start the game. The fourth and final. If there was one more to go, we'd be able to do it.
I think so.
I don't think two more to go.
No, two no.
Konopka. Hook shot. No good. Put back up again. No good. Again. No good.
Three for a quarter.
He got three shots at the basket.
He's big. He's strong underneath.
Garrity quickly hands off to Johnson. And a
count
foul
it.
And good and foul. Looks like O'Gorman might have caught the foul there. Yeah. James Miller. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Number five. David Osher will go to the line.
Yes. He made the basket and he shoots
got
one.
It.
I didn't get to who fouled him. Well, we'll catch it. So right now, Mac McCoy says, let's end this game right now. All right.
Sharma brings it up. He's a good one. He's a good point guard. Here comes Sharma. Glasser tries to get it in to Konopka. Glasser will shoot from the outside. No good. Rebounded by Garrity.
Nice
throws
crossover.
It back outside to Johnson. No good. Konopka with the rebound. Hands to O'Gorman. O'Gorman. Konopka once. Just puts it up. The left hand. And a running left hand that makes it a 3-2 game. Ridgewood. Asha's bringing it up.
They are missing cheerleaders today.
Him
you can see it.
Hit the Johnson.
Oh, a little spin.
from outside, and a whistle, and I think Usher was fouled.
He'll get
again.
Three. He'll get three shots. Three shots. It was a three-point attempt.
Let's see who the foul was on.
Dawkins.
Yep. At the free throw line for three shots. Number five, Davis Osher.
That's Mike Troy, the coach for Ridgewood.
We got three foul shots here.
Yeah, who fouled that last one, John?
Maybe Sharma?
I believe it was Sharma.
I got him.
Okay. So Osher hits one or two. He's got one more to go. And he makes it. So it's 5-2 now. Just the beginning of things here. Sharma brings it up. Glashen inside the Canup. And he lays it in. They're going to have a hard time keeping him. If they can't keep him out of the paint.
You got to box him out. You got to put another, or even put two people on it. He's strong. 6'7".
Yeah. Stolen by Mora. Hands to Sharma. Back over to Mora. Taken back the other way by Usher. Has a man on the wing. Yeah, gives it to him on the wing, and he gets the basket.
Number 23 up for the basket.
Favieri with the basket.
Representing Italy.
You know, he sounds like my name.
He's Favieri.
Yeah.
You got to give a little Italian to it.
Maybe I'll say it once. Kanapka. Going the other way. This is what you got to do. When he gets the ball, you may have to put three guys around him. He'll dish it out, but let them hit it. Let them hit a 10-footer or 12-footer instead of laying it up. Very difficult to defend a young man like that.
And you have Bruce Dawkins came in, number three for Ridgewood.
Ben Garrity holds it up. Working with McGlashan. Garrity, oh, what a shot. Puts it in over McGlashan.
Yeah, nice runner with that and the steal.
Oh, and taken back by Kanapka. Kanapka will play guard as he brings it up all the way. And they got a foul.
Number five on the foul, Usher.
Number three is in, John said, Bryce Dawkins for Ridgewood.
He's got two shots.
Victor puts the first one up and hits. Favieri's back in. And I believe Dawkins is sitting down. That was quick. Kanapka's, so he makes two, and it's a 9-6 game. Ridgewood leads.
Kanapka's got six.
He's got six of the 9 points. Usher bringing it up.
Well, he's got six out of six.
No, bouncing around. And that's
a nice play
by Miller. He got to knock the ball off Kanapka's foot.
Stayed up and found the foot.
Found the foot.
Oh, Jeff, he's going to keep us inside the barricade.
Mora bangs it, saved. That ball was almost pushed away. Garrity has. Johnson. Giant. Miller. Garrity. Johnson. Hold the ball. Outside. Long jump shot, no good by Garrity. Taken down by Mora. Up to Kanapka. Throws it back out. McGlashan from the left side. Bounces around. Taken by Miller. Garrity. Stolen by McGlashan. The way we go the other way. Sharma has. Brings it into forecourt. Sharma. And we have a whistle. They're going to call.
Charge.
A charge on three. Sharma gets their foul.
Mike McCoy, the head coach, Mike Troy, should say.
Isaiah Williams is in for Don Bosco Prince.
What's a Troy? Troy McCoy. We thought McCoy number 24 for Dwight Engler was here.
Shot is no good. Konopka will have it. Hands to O'Gorman. O'Gorman quickly into the forecourt. Oh! Ooh, Mauer went flying, and they're going to call a foul. Mauer. That was a personal, that was a offensive foul.
Yeah.
Player control foul, call it what you want.
I think it was McClashin, right? Number 10, I believe, was the foul on.
Yep, I believe it was.
If not, well, we'll wait to halftime. Yep.
And a foul.
Well, the assistant coach for Troy is Joe Del Buono.
There he is, Joe Del Buono, longtime coach in Bergen County, was the co-head coach at the Ramapo for a number of years. He's now doing the assistant coaching in Ridgewood. And a longtime friend of WCTV.
I met him when Peggy graduated nursing school.
That's how long ago.
That's right,
John Garrity. Miller. Johnson.
Hey, Rich was doing a nice job.
And a walk. Just when you said they were doing a nice job.
They're passing.
Kevin DeVario is calling the signals here for Don Bosco.
And you want to maintain, you want to hold the ball and get a good shot. But you can't walk.
9-6. Now Ridgewood leads in a low-scoring game.
Pat, looks like number two, Pat O'Gorman, came in.
Yeah, he's in. He started, went out, come back in now.
And number 20, Isaiah Williams.
Yeah, he's in. 15 is in now for Bosco. Get his name.
Stewart, Nick Stewart.
There he goes.
Ah, I'll tell you what, they're moving in fast on us.
Out to Gorman. Long shot. Good. And a timeout. With the score 9-9. This is the name of the arena, the Stratus Arena.
Eli
FTU alum and member of the Board of Trustees. His devotion to the Fairleigh Dickinson University was second to none. This was done November 29th, 1989. Ilya G. Stratus. This is the Stratus Village.
That was in 1989, it was named.
And the lounge above us, which is all enclosed with glass, that lounge is named after this gentleman. Elijah G. Stratus. It is the Stratus Arena.
Stratus Arena, so we can't make that mistake again.
No.
Listen, we got to make some mistakes. We can't be perfect. So 9-9 with 2:11 to go in the first quarter in our fourth game.
Matt Ferriero, you put it in.
We're getting that second win, Larry.
I think so, Asha. Quickly. Ooh, almost ran out of bounds and did. That's an error. McGlashan will throw it in.
A little full court press, a relaxed full court press.
O'Gorman over to McGlashan. Out to Stewart. Williams. Konopka wants a long one, short. Comes back to Usher. Usher all the way down. Outside, shot, no good. That was by Favieri.
Off, 23.
Oh, looks like
it's Konopka. Yeah. That's Eagle Eye Francola makes that call.
So, Ridgewood will throw it in. We're all tied here with 1:32 to go. Low scoring first quarter, only 9 points by both teams. Favieri. No good. Konopka with the rebound. Hands to O'Gorman. O'Gorman. Stewart looking inside to Konopka. Cut off. Goes outside to McGlashan. Has the look. Bounces around. No good. Taken by Favieri.
Oh.
They're going to say, oh, Favieri, good play by O'Gorman defensively.
They got a charge against play control part for Favieri.
That was a good play anyway by O'Gorman.
Oh, I totally agree.
So 1-0-1 to go in the first period. Here comes O'Gorman. O'Gorman into the forecourt. Throws out. Stewart, Konopka, gets it in.
8 points for Konopka.
Yeah, he did it. 30 seconds to go here.
11-9 score. I think they're doing this so
Johnson,
you and I can get some
23
second
seconds
win.
To go. Stewart is watching him. Johnson out to Garrity. 10 seconds. Nice move. No good. Konopka with the rebound and a whistle. With 5.1 seconds to go. I think the foul is on number two, John. I'm not 100% sure.
Let's wait and see. Devin Johnson.
Who is it?
Devin Johnson, number one.
So
and that's
Johnson,
not a shooting foul, so.
It goes O'Gorman. It's good if it goes, and it didn't go. So we have played one quarter here at the Stratus Arena at the Rodman Center on the campus of Fairleigh Dickens University in Hackensack. The score is 11-9. Don Bosco leads Ridgewood.
11-9.
You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer group from the Township of Washington. Okay, Carradine will throw it in right in front of me.
John Carney, number 14.
DJ Sullivan's in.
O'Gorman will throw the ball in right in front of us, Larry.
That's right. Number 11, I see.
It's Garrity
in.
Throwing the ball in.
So he hands the ball to DJ Sullivan, and away we go, third quarter. Sullivan tries to feed inside. He does, and gets his man, Mike Leah. Sharma.
11-11.
O'Gorman outside to Williams. No good.
Oh!
And a jump ball. It's going to go the other way.
Against 23.
Let's see. Is that a foul? Oh, yeah.
Reaching and grabbing.
You can't reach and grab. You can grab and reach.
So 11-11.
Sullivan brings it up. Garrity is on his wing. Garrity has. Osher back outside.
That's Kent Carney.
Oh, they got a foul of 14.
Yeah, that's James Carney.
James, boy, he whacked somebody.
Number 14, John Carney. First personal foul on Carney, 14
foul. No, 14. 14 is the foul.
James Carney called
James
for
Carney.
An offensive or player control foul. I like calling it offensive foul. I don't know. You had the ball, so you made a foul, they call it offense. I don't like player control. I think it should be player uncontrolled. Here's Osher with the steal.
Oh!
And a foul.
He'll get two.
McGlashan will go to the line.
That'll be a second foul for McGlashan.
Charge to number 10, Noah McGlashan. His first personal foul, 17 foul.
I thought it was a second, but.
So Osher will go to the line, try to break this tie. Misses the first one. James Miller is in. And let's see, Devin Johnson is in.
Well, they're doing a lot of substitution right now.
Too bad we don't have anybody to substitute for us. You know.
Well, yeah. I think right here, Larry, he's going to take over.
Yeah, that little guy.
The little guy. He breaks the tie.
The little lion. You're going to take over in the second half.
12-11. 6:49 to go in the second quarter.
Sharman almost stolen. Kanapka has, looking for Sharman, throws the ball away. Well, he was looking for him. I shouldn't say he threw the ball away. He was just looking for
him. He was looking for it. He didn't go, and he assumed he was going.
Yeah, he one zigged when he should have zigged. All right.
So, 12-11, 6:36 in the second
Sullivan
quarter.
Sullivan brings it up.
Oh, a hook shot. I thought he was going to throw a little hook shot.
He did it. A nice job. And nicely put in by James Miller on a rebound. And it's 14-11. Ridgewood leading Don Bosco.
He's got, you know, Mike Troy's got these kids really playing right now.
McGlashan. Kanapka will chop from the outside. He'll be short, but Bosco's under it. And no good. And taken down by number 13. James Miller, we have time. That one, yeah, she could do a good job taking over. Hey, John,
absolutely.
We have number 42 for Don Bosco Prep. And he's the aforementioned Mr. Smith.
Mr. Smith.
I think he's sitting down, Mr. Smith. We'll find out at the half who Mr. Smith is.
Well, I think we can give him the name Mr. Smith. Case closed. We got to have at least one Mr. Smith in four games. Now they're having a little discussion.
So Johnson will put it in. Sullivan puts it in. Asha has moving. Gets inside, puts it up, and they walk.
A little walk.
Hey, listen, if we get tired, we're going to have Leon's aide over here who will help us. You'll help us, right? Can you put some helmet? There's Leon over there. Put a little couple of headsets. You couldn't do any worse than us, right?
He's a silent partner.
Yeah, very silent. Stay that way. Williams.
You know, you've seen great defensive battle right now, Larry. Everybody's moving.
Williams working.
Oh!
What happened over there? 14.
Well, number 20.
Carney was there.
To 14.
And a foul.
Making cup substitution.
Maurer is in. And Stewart is out for Don Bosco.
Carney's got two fouls for Ridgewood.
And he's going to sit down quickly.
That's the reason why.
Kanapka to McGlashan. Maurer backing it up. Williams. McGlashan stops, shoots, no good. Rebound to Favieri. And a timeout by Ridgewood with 5:05 to go. They lead in a very low-scoring game, John.
Don Bosco hasn't scored in this quarter. Very, very, a lot of great defense.
The Bergen County Coach Association and the Jamboree Committee, thanks to the generosity of our sponsors, Lifesavers, Inc., Sports Time, Direct It, Gourmet Dining, and WCTV. Thank you all for supporting this year's Jamboree. And there is your score. Your time, we're in the second quarter. And that's the Don Bosco huddle. I was talking to Kevin DeVario last week and he said about Bobby Maines and I believe he said that he's got a couple of injuries. Two of his kids were injuries and we heard that I think
well, you can see that they're not
was hurt. So no excuses, just to let you know that they learn how to play with different people now. That may take a little time.
Oh, I totally agree with you, Larry. Yeah. Ruth is out, right? Miles Ruth is out. Normal starter.
Say that?
Miles Ruth.
Yeah.
You know, when you miss one or two starters, it affects the whole flow of the game.
Especially if they like ball handlers. Johnson throws it in. J. James Miller. Doesn't take away the great game that Ridgewood's playing. They are playing an outstanding game so far.
Well, don't forget, they play against a lot of tough teams.
Favieri gets in, loses the ball, comes out to Sharman, quickly to Mara, McGlashan. Into give and go to Konopka, and that was pretty. McGlashan and Konopka, the two seniors, have done that a few times in the last couple of years.
He's got 10 points of the 13.
We are a one-point game with Ridgewood leading 14-13. Make it another 2 points.
That's number five.
Asha with 2 points, make it 16-13. Sharma bringing the ball up. Sharma looking, trying to work. Williams back out to Mara, inside to Konopka. Konopka throws it out to Sharma, back to McLaughlin. McGlashan throws it back out to Sharma, and away we go again.
Yeah.
Good defense by Ridgewood, excellent. And the ball gets thrown away.
They're moving extremely well.
Ridgewood's playing at a high level here, John, very high level. 16-13 they lead. Don Bosco only scored 13 points in almost a half.
Right, and Osher has got 8 points.
Yeah.
Number five. Well, you know, when you're missing a couple of players, your flow gets really messed up.
Ooh. Osher. Milt.
And a turnover.
Yep.
Number three, Sharma, made a nice steal.
Konopka inside. And McGlashan, a give and go the other way. So McGlashan and Konopka.
A one-point game.
Nick Stewart's going to come in. Favieri inside. Garrity. Johnson will back it up. Favieri. Williams pushes to kind of to go backwards. Johnson driving. Miller throws back out to Asha. Asha, Johnson.
Oh.
Moves the basket, no good. Sharma with the rebound. 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the half. Konopka to McGlashan, back in.
And they take a lead by one.
Don Bosco takes the lead with Konopka and McGlashan playing give and go.
Between them, they have 14 points.
There you go.
A couple of new plays waiting to come in for Don Bosco.
Garrity. Favieri. Now Asha. Watched by Williams. Gets around Williams. Stops, jumps. No good. McGlashan with the rebound. Off the glass. Quickly down court to Williams. Williams cross court to Sharma. Back over to McGlashan. Williams wants it. No good. Taken down by Favieri. Quickly over to Johnson. Johnson puts it up. Knocked away by Konopka.
Did a great job.
O'Gorman and Stewart will come in. And number five also.
Well, you know
Connor
what it
Mathis.
Is. Coach DeVario is trying to get some kind of group coming in just to create some offense. They have a one-point lead.
And a foul. James Miller was fouled as he got inside. So Miller would go to the line. Who's that, 20?
Against Konopka.
23, Konopka.
That's his second foul.
No good. Miller, Mr. Frank, we have 1:35 to go in the half. Bryce Dawkins coming in for Ridgewood.
You got to make foul shots, Larry.
Well, that was off by a lot.
Well, St. Joe's was perfect tonight with foul shots in that third game.
Mathis ball is almost ran over the great Brian Carr.
Brian Carr.
Hey, we got to thank Brian Carr for bringing us the coffee.
Oh, the
cakes.
The cappuccino was fantastic.
Keeps us going.
I'm going to run home.
He said, yeah, I'm going to put you outside my car and you're going to pull it. Mara hits it for three. And it's 20-16. Don Bosco now takes the lead.
That was a nice shot by Mara.
We have a whistle. What happened here? One, a shot on the arm. Mara is fouled. Johnson, one fouled one. I think, nope. They're going to say 23 got fouled, Favieri.
So Favieri on the line.
101 to go in the half.
One plus one. They're getting killed on foul shots.
Yeah. Okay. Well, Favieri hits that one. He gets the second one now. 3-point lead now for Don Bosco.
Make it two.
And makes it a 2-point game with a minute to go in the half. O'Gorman gets around Sullivan. Ooh.
Oh, that's a great play.
And they're going to call it jump ball.
But that's a great play by number 21 that time, diving DJ Sullivan, I believe.
Let's see, the ball's going to?
They go to?
Bosco.
Yeah. You got the nice arrow by the Jamboree over there. So you and I could see.
Nice color.
Oh, it is nice.
Williams will trigger it in. McGlashan fires, jump, good from the outside. O'Gorman again for
he's
three.
He's got two threes.
Yeah. You give him an opening, he'll hit it.
So it's a 5-point game in favor of Don Bosco.
23-18. 30 seconds to go in the half. 23-18. Don Bosco leads Ridgewood. Sullivan. Watched by O'Gorman. Sullivan stops, throws it back out. 18 seconds to go. Johnson watched by McGlashan. Still watching. Sullivan back outside. Johnson throws it there. Puts it up. Shot no good. Taken down by Bosco, and that'll do it for the half. 23-18 as the last 3 minutes belong to Don Bosco as they overcame a slight underdog roll. They're losing by 2 3-points. And they are now 23-18 as we get ready for the second half. It is cookie time. This is the time of year to buy your Girl Scout cookies. I got a lot to buy. Here is a video put together by Daisy Velez Martinez and a brownie troop from the Township of Washington. Enjoy and support your local Girl Scouts, like Larry LaFury has to do with his granddaughters.
I could sell Girl Scout cookies. Of course, it's inside you. It's inside all of us. And I don't think it, I feel it.
We got the Sizzlers with Dosey Dose. It's got the treat for coffee testing. Tag along. They're so tasty, can't have just one. Just open up your wallet and buy a whole bunch.
We got those orders in our pockets.
With those cookies that are sweet.
You feel that rumble in your belly.
With each box.
Ooh. You can take your eyes off them. Saving so phenomenally.
You're gonna love those Girl Scout cookies. So don't stop.
You should
order now.
Cause everything goes.
Don't wait to buy them cause you never know.
Stop. When you taste then, well, you know.
Let's go, let's work.
So just imagine.
Just imagine.
Just imagine.
How about a box of Thin Mints?
Yum, yum, yum.
What about the tasty Samoas?
Yum, yum, yum.
You know you want delicious s'mores.
Yum, yum, yum.
Can't forget Savannah Smiles.
Yum, yum, yum.
Can't stop the craving.
So just buy.
Bye, bye, bye.
Can't stop the craving.
Can't stop the craving.
Can't stop the craving.
Well, we are back here for the second half of the fourth game, which means we can go home after this game. We've been told we can go home. Don Bosco leads 23-18 over Ridgewood. And I got to find my glasses or I'm not doing anything. Oh, here we are. All right.
Looks like the starter back in for Don Bosco.
So we have Asha will trigger it in. Hands off there to number 13, Miller. So we have Johnson, Garrity, Asha, Miller, and Favieri. It's the starters.
In a 5-point game.
That's for Ridgewood. And the starters are the same for Bosco. Mora, Gorman, Sharman, McGlashkin, and Konopka.
There's a big shot for number 23, Favieri.
Favieri hits to three, and we got a 2-point game, 23-21, Sharma. Okay, Sharma, inside. Lays it up and in, and that was Konopka.
He's got 12 points.
So it's 25-21. Garrity, ball's knocked away by Sharma. And
that was nice job by the referee.
Yes, he said it was tipped away. It wasn't, wouldn't be a penalty. Shot is no good. And a foul, Asha, over the top of Gorman, called for the foul.
Oh, that was outstanding job by the one referee following the play and making the call.
So Sharma brings the ball up. He will shoot. No good. Taken down by Garrity. Through the basket. Hands over to Johnson. Watched by O'Gorman. Garrity shoot in and out. McGlashan with the rebound. That one in, down, up, and out of bounds. I think off the hands of a Don Bosco player, probably
absolutely.
O'Gorman. Yes, it was. And the ball will turn over to the Maroon. Asha will bring it up. Garrity, Favieri, Asha driving, puts it up. No good. McGlashan with the rebound. Hands to Sharma. Sharma, cross court. O'Gorman puts it up.
Oh, what a nice.
And knocked away by Johnson. Devin
what a
Johnson.
Nice defense. Tell you one thing about this game, both teams are playing a great defense against each other. A low scoring game, but
Not like we saw the last game.
No, no, that was...
Konopka is fouled.
He'll shoot two.
And I believe Miller. That's it. Miller got the foul. Number 13.
Personal foul. Number 13, James Miller. First personal foul.
So next week's semifinals games, ladies and gentlemen, will be at 1 and 3 o'clock. Now you come, watch the doubleheader, you get home, you go out to dinner, relax at night.
And we get home earlier.
Yeah, oh, get home real for us. Oh, boy, that'd be great.
Yeah, we'll leave everything here.
One out of here. And Konopka gets two.
He's got 14 points.
You know, he'll wind up with 25 points into the game very quietly.
Oh, he's a force in that game.
Oh, yes.
6'7" strong.
Here's O'Gorman. And puts it in. 29-28. Don Bosco leads. Osher brings it down. Don Bosco's tightening their defense up a little bit. Ball was tipped.
Yep.
Konopka, that's defense. Konopka has the rebound. Sharman now gets it back to Konopka.
Oh.
And there's a foul.
Ooh. Ah.
Personal foul. Jordan Ridgewood, number 38, James Miller.
Dave Miller on the foul.
So Victor Konopka will go to the line. Hits the first one.
Substitution for Ridgewood, number 31. Michael A.M. replaces James Miller. One shot for Konopka.
He's been perfect on the line.
Yes, he has.
5 for 5, going for 6.
Hits that. So Konopka, another 2 points. Adds this total. Now it's a 10-point Don Bosco lead. And they're going to call. It looks like they want a timeout. Coach Troy wants a timeout.
He wants to bring the cross and the timeout.
That's it. Got the ball across the timeline and he called a timeout. So with 5 minutes, 4 minutes, 55 seconds left in the third quarter, 31-21, Don Bosco leads Ridgewood. You are watching WCTV, all volunteer cable access group from the township of Washington, Bergen County. We'll be airing the Jamboree games through March. So if you enjoy basketball and you want to see some great games, you're able to see it on our different systems through March. You can check our schedule on Facebook and Twitter. You can go to WCTVNJ and our website, www.wctv.us. And go out and get Girl Scout cookies, nice glass of milk, and eat a box or two, like
and
I do.
And let him come over and give us a couple of cookies.
Oh, I get you want cookies?
No, no.
Oh, I got cookies.
No, it's against my body.
Oh, my God.
My body doesn't want to have it.
I got 5 granddaughters who are
Girl Scouts?
Girl Scouts.
That's always, about $100.
They always lead the troop. In.
Well, they got to give $100, easy.
Just tell me how much you want. The problem is I got to eat them, John. I love cookies, I can't say no. Marlowe's on the floor, let's see if they get the ball. One push, so that's Johnson. The problem is, they bring over a bag full of cookies, and I start eating them.
That was on Mora.
Who's it on?
On number one,
Johnson.
John Mora. His third foul.
That's Mora's third foul?
Yes.
Wow.
His fourth.
Fourth
foul. So he's one of the starters, so that's a big foul.
Yeah, he's sitting on the bench. Favieri. Osho, watched by Sharma. No good. Sharma with the rebound. To Williams.
Oh.
Comes the other way. Lost. Konopka. No good. Williams lays it in. The ball just bounced to Williams, and he laid it in.
That's his first 2 points for Williams. It's 3 points at this point for Maroons, and
Garrity tries to get it in, stolen, or knocked away. McCashin has it, hands over to Sharman. Sharman will bring it up as he calls a play. Substitutes will be coming in for Ridgewood. Stolen by Ridgewood, that's Johnson.
Yep.
Puts it up, no good, and they're gonna call a blocking foul, I believe, on Gorman.
Let's wait.
Calls on number two.
On Gorman.
Second personal, second team.
And Devin Johnson will shoot two.
He will go to two. And he...
Devin Johnson.
James Miller's coming in. DJ Sullivan's coming in. And that's it, that's it. Favieri's in, Johnson shoots. That's Miller's in.
So, 10-point game.
And James Carney's in for Ridgewood. Sharma brings it up. O'Gorman comes around looking for the shot. Kanapka dribbling in. No good, but McGlashan gets the rebound and puts it in. 12-point lead now for Don Bosco. Very workmanlike game here today, John.
You know, both of those two individuals are scoring inside. They're tough to guard. 12-point lead right now.
Nice shot outside by Favieri. 3 points.
That's his second three-pointer.
35-26. John.
He's got to shoot more. He's got 10 points. Favieri.
Sharma's calling out a play. McGlashan. Good. He's got to get more involved in the game, and he did.
Well, now you're looking at 12-point lead.
Yeah, 38-26, Bosco leads. Nice shot. DJ Sullivan. Wide open shot. Took it. Thank you very much. Go the other way. Sharma brings it up.
Well, the offenses are starting to make some points, both teams.
Sharma outside to Gorman for three, no good. Taken down by McGlashan, turn, shoots, no good. Taken down by Kanapka, puts it up, no good. Taken by Williams and a whistle.
So number 23 will go to the line.
Stewart's coming in when he gets a chance for Don Bosco. Kanapka will go to the line.
For two.
He will get two.
He's been perfect on the line.
Still perfect.
He now has 6-7 foul shots. Oh, he misses the first.
Hey, finally missed one. Well, you know what? Can't make them all.
Well, here's St. Joe's at.
Oh, yeah, they did. Usually you can't make them all.
You're right.
Sullivan has a lane, and he's tripped and falls to the ground, and they're going to call a block.
McGlashan on the foul.
All right, it's McGlashan's foul. That'll be the third team foul.
His third.
Second.
James Carney back in, number 14. Oh. Carney didn't get the rim. Taken down by Kanapka. Sharma has
11-point lead. 1:32 to go in the third quarter.
McGlashan. Kanapka is fouled.
Back on the charity line.
And Kanapka's going back on the line.
He's 7-for-8 from the line.
Personal foul guards to number 4, Ridgewood. Matt DeFeo, his first personal foul, 15 miles. Kanapka in the line.
First one dribbles in.
He's an excellent foul shooter, by the way. He's only missed one.
Matt DeFeo, number four, is in for Ridge. You want to mention that.
Now in the game for the Ironman, number four, Hydro Cumber.
Oh, Matt DeFeo goes out. I just mentioned him.
Konopka's 9-for-10 from the line.
Not bad.
When you're a big guy like that, you can shoot foul shots.
They're giving him a breather.
Yeah, he's kind of tired. You and I got to get a breather.
Nah, we're fine.
You're right.
And a foul.
Nick Stewart on a foul.
Number 15, Nicholas Stewart. His first personal foul.
Miller will shoot two, I believe.
I
believe so. So first shot for Miller with 108 to go in the third. Hits the first one. No
one
good.
For two.
Matt DeFeo gets the rebound. Johnson back to DeFeo. Stops, looks.
Oh.
Stolen. Keller. Mike Keller, who checked in. Got the ball handed over to Sharma with 49 seconds to go. They're putting a one up. I don't know if that means one play or one shot. Oh, we're going to go one play. Now we'll test Bobby Maines' corollary again today. He's been perfect.
This time, if they hold it till the end, they're gonna, they're playing little pass back and forth.
Yeah, if they don't put any pressure on it, then they can hold it for
the
last shot. And they're not gonna put pressure on.
Down to 15 seconds.
Carney's running back and forth here. Here we go, 12 seconds. McGlashan looking in. Williams. Sharma, no good. McGlashan somehow has it. Stops, looks, shoots. For three, it would have been good if it goes. It didn't go. So we have three quarters in the book. 41-29.
Did you tell him that his system doesn't work?
Well, they didn't put any pressure on them.
Well.
We'd like to thank George Kuzma and Gourmet Dani for providing food today for everyone here that worked in Jamboree, the committee, and WCTV. Gourmet Dani is the premier and largest food service company serving New Jersey. We operate on-site food service, management service, colleges in Northeast region, as well as corporate, healthcare, and many long-term care facilities throughout the area. Gourmet Dani takes pride in creating unique dining experience specific to each campus served with a staff of a full 2,000 full-time employees, and they have 500 part-time employees. Just to give you an idea of some of the schools, universities they service: Seton Hall University, the New Jersey Institute of Technology, Fairleigh Dickinson University at Teaneck, Fairleigh Dickinson University at Madison, Seton Hall Prep, Bloomfield College, Kane, Bergen Community College in Glenhurst, Caldwell University, Manhattan College, Jersey City University, Rowan, Monmouth University, Stephen Student College, Rutgers University, and Rutgers University at Camden, New Jersey, 2018, that's new. Thank you, George Kuzma, for supplying the food for us. You're a wonderful corporate sponsor. As we start the fourth quarter.
So
here we go, McGlashan throws it out in front of me. Stewart has now. Over to Sharma. Watched by Carney. And we play back and forth here. Isaiah Williams had a lot of time today. A couple of the plays for Bosco were injured prior to the game. There's a steal. And up and in by DJ Sullivan.
Hey.
10-point game. There's Nick. Thank Nick. Inside, Isaiah Williams puts it up and he lays it in. there's Lou Serbio on the camera, high above us. Shot is no good by Carney. Taken down by Kudupka. Sharma brings it across. Sharma out to Williams. Williams, no good. Taken down on a rebound by Johnson. Johnson brings it up. Johnson drives inside, pushes it back outside. Carney. Long three-pointer. Good! Oh. Matt DeFeo gets on the, gets in the book. There's Emily. Wave to Emily. How are you, Emily?
9-point game, Larry. 6:25 to go.
Does get interesting. McGlashkin gives a three-pointer.
So just like that, back to 12 with the three-point shot by McGlashan.
From the outside,
another
good.
Three.
Johnson for three. There's Ricky Wojcicki, there he is. Sharma.
Back to 9 points.
So it, they're gonna call walk.
Now they're calling foul.
What are they calling, a foul?
Yes, offensive foul.
And there's Ida, our director, who's serving time since about 10 o'clock this morning. She can't get out.
She can't get out, look at her.
We're sending a bail bondsman to get you out in about 5 minutes and 45 seconds.
We just took a collection. We got about $1.32 for you.
No, Brian Carr took that money to buy
Oh, look at this.
Lays it in. That would be James Miller. And the game gets a little closer. 46-39.
7 points. Ridgewood Maroons is putting up some great defense. Oh!
And they're going to call a foul.
Good job.
Powers with the foul. Jared Powers. I wonder what that little girl is watching. She watched the whole game. She must find. She's looking for a better scene.
Oh look, she's texting. You're right. She is texting.
McGlashan saves it. And Kanapka slams it home with a foul. They're going to count
the
foul.
House call that time.
21, DJ Sullivan with the foul.
A power slam. He's only missed one foul shot. Let's see. Oh, he missed another one.
Larson tried to save it, he couldn't. Garrity had it, push it inside. The ball trickles out of bounds. We'll turn over to Don Bosco. We're under 5 minutes to go in the day.
Nine-point game. The game is still...
Same still a doubt.
There to have with almost 5 minutes. Oh, look at this, a little double team.
McGlashkin brings it up. Kanapka, no good. Mara tried to get up there, just didn't time his jump right. Garrity. Ball. McGlashkin. And they're going to call a walk.
A little walk.
On Stewart.
Larry, you know, we should mention, this referee, the three of them are doing a great job on this game.
Nice job today. Up and down, they did
all
a
of them
job.
Have done a great job.
So 4:34 to go, 48-39. Don Bosco leads. Ridgewood, you are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer group from the Township of Washington, Bergen County, New Jersey.
You know, Larry,
Lifesavers. Lifesavers provides emergency medical response products and training to businesses, the public sector, and other organizations nationwide. Established in 1992, Lifesavers, Inc. works closely with its customers to design, implement, and continually assess safety and emergency response programs. John?
Both teams have about the same amount of turnover. One different about 14 to 13. Bosco with 14 turnovers. It's been an even game there. And right now we got a 9-point game.
No team can break open the game, so it's going to stay close. It looks like it's going to stay close down to the last 2-3 minutes. Then you'll see the score, and the score might be a little longer and say, well, that game was really one-sided, but it wasn't. I think the games today, all of them, although they look like double-digit victories, they were a lot closer than the score indicates.
Konopka's done a great job. He's got 21 points. My MVP, without him, would be a tough day. And Ridgewood's done a great job. You know, there'll be a force in the state.
Ridgewood. I think so, yeah.
He's got some nice players.
We've seen some teams today that we're going to watch throughout when the state start in about 2 weeks.
Mike Troy does a great job with these kids.
Yeah.
And so does DeVario for Don Bosco.
Two good young coaches. Johnson hits from the outside. Three.
That's the second three.
48-42.
So Johnson doing a nice job of two threes in this quarter.
Konopka puts it out to Sharma. Sharma feeds inside. Flashing, stops, looks, shoots, no good. Konopka puts it up and in. That's what makes him so difficult. That's why Bosco's so tough. He got the rebound.
He's so strong, Larry.
He went over a defender, took the rebound, and put it up. Bounced, stolen. Mara has. Hands over to Sharma. Sharma lost. Can't go with the ball without the ball. Somehow Stewart got the ball and he was pushed.
Personal foul.
Matt DeFeo coming in, number four.
How many rebounds does Konopka have?
10?
Konopka's got 10 rebounds.
No stats brought to you by Bobby Maines.
And he's got 23 points.
Eight-point game, and Nick Stewart will go on the line for Don Bosco. Hits the first one. O'Gorman looks like he's going to check in. He is. So O'Gorman will check in.
10-point, Larry.
Now with 3:25 to go, so Ridgewood's got a lot of work to do.
It's still available.
A couple of threes and you're right back in the game.
And they've been shooting the three.
They got to call an illegal pick here on, I believe it was number two, Cavity.
On four, number four, Matt DeFeo. Illegal pick.
Okay.
All right.
Sharma. Mauer. Sharma puts it up, no good. Konopka is fighting for it, loses the battle to Miller. Johnson. Favieri now has a look at this basket and hits.
A two.
Matt Favieri for 2 points.
He's got 12 for the game.
52-44. Sharma, point. Now they're sending some good picks here, John. McGlashan. O'Gorman. He falls down.
They're
going to call a walk.
A little traveling music. On turnover, they're all even. 15 on 15.
52-44.
Well, we're still 8 points. Anybody's game.
Oh, yeah, with 2 minutes to go and change.
Three.
Johnson for three.
Ask me how many Johnson threes he's got in this quarter. Three.
Sharma.
5-point game. 2 minutes to go.
McGlashan. Bauer. No good. McGlashan has it. O'Gorman and a foul.
Oh.
O'Gorman did the right thing. He pushed it into Konopka, who went up and he was fouled with 1:48 to go. It's 52-47.
And number 23 made a career shooting foul shots. So he's going to have two shots from
so
the
we
line.
We have a timeout. All right, here's how it all started back in round one. See, the teams played at Bergen Catholic and I believe Bergenfield.
All right.
And then this is round of 16 at Northern Highlands and Tenafly. That got us to the quarterfinals today. And so far, Ramapo and Bergen Catholic won earlier. St. Joe's won, and now we have the question mark for the final game, for the final four, we will call them.
And you have 1, 2, 3, 4 if Don Bosco wins it. So the committee has done a great job picking.
So Konopka can extend this lead and does by one, 53-47. Now, Ridgewood's going to have to start fouling here.
Yeah.
This is the old foul.
And shoot the three. You got to get. Now they got to shoot fast.
Whistle.
Put on number two on the foul.
O'Gorman.
On Pat O'Gorman.
They're not in a shooting penalty, so.
You're right. They got six. Next one, they will shoot.
And we have a jump ball. DJ Sullivan was on the bottom of that.
And number two, Pat O'Gorman, I believe. Six points. Game is still available for Ridgewood.
Two possessions and a timeout on the court. 1:33 to go. It's a two-possession game, 53-47. You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer cable access television group from the Township of Washington. Now, you can contact us with your comments. Here's how you do it now. You call 201-664-9821 if you loved everything, and I'll answer. If you got any comments or criticism, send them to Frank Cole, who's in charge of our criticism department. And John will give it attention.
Absolutely.
That it needs. Yeah, you send it to him. Any complaints that you don't like, that you don't, send it to him. He will file it and then tell us what we did wrong and try to improve it.
He's there to help. You gotta trust that guy.
All you have to do is just address it to John. Forget every other name. Just say John.
6 points. 1:33 to go.
It's been a wonderful day, hasn't it?
Absolutely. I love every minute.
It seems like such a long day when you first sit down and they tip the ball. And when you get to this point, you go, wow, it went fast.
Well, the espresso put us over there.
Oh, we want to thank Brian Carr for that espresso. It goes, you know, Brian, you don't hear it, but every time we mention your name, that car.
Brian Carr.
The great Brian Carr.
One more time. Brian Carr. One more. Brian Carr. I think we're losing it. Larry, we're gone.
Uh-oh, something happened while we were bringing our horn in.
Uh-oh.
Let's see what goes on.
All right. They're doing a nice job with this. This is what you got to do. You got to talk to Bulk. They gave the ball to Ridgewood.
Okay. So Ridgewood gets the ball. And explaining it to Jim McConville, and DeVario's going to go over and listen into this conversation. Yeah.
All right, we take a little break.
Yeah, we're sitting here relaxing. It's been a nice day. We want to thank the Jamboree Committee for inviting us to do these games.
We had a ball.
Oh, yeah. Listen, we got the best seat in the house, bar
none. Oh, I totally
agree.
And
we watch everything.
This is great.
Ah. And next week, the game's 1 and 3 o'clock. We'll be all home early. Have a nice dinner. Relax.
Bailey got the ball in, by the way, to number one.
Yeah, Johnson has.
He's the three-point shooter.
Oh, yeah, they're going to try to get something. Johnson puts it up, rims the basket. Sharman has it. Goes over to Mara. Sharman has it. Back to O'Gorman. Looks like they're going to want a foul.
Well, they want to try to steal the ball with 6 points. We got a minute, 66 seconds.
Sharma. McGlaskin.
They don't have to shoot.
We're inside a minute now. Mara. And they call a timeout. DeVario called the timeout.
Wants
with
to
53
set up a play.
Seconds to go.
Still in doubt this game. 6 points.
If you get to under a minute, the game is still in doubt. What? We can't answer any better than that.
Tell you, referees have done a super job all day today.
Nice job.
Look at Johnson in his corner. Three threes for nine.
There they are, the refs.
You see, this is what you got to do as referees. You want to make sure now, 53.4 seconds, everybody's got to know what we're going to be doing.
This is the Bergen County Coach Association. Joe Spafford, Colin Church, Sean Buchanan, Howie Conklin, Ed Shearer, and Joe DelBuno, the Bergen County Jamboree Committee, Paul Bluglis and Ed Cromwell, the co-chairman, Leon Steinberg, John Ryan, Rookie Corcoran, Chris Annabelle, the Bergen County Coach Association liaison, the three of them, Tom Curry, Chris Gaskin, and Michael Cibula. Going to throw the ball in right in front of me. McGlaskin will do the honors.
Well, they don't have to shoot. They could just freeze the ball.
I'm too busy.
5 seconds.
There's a 5 second.
5 seconds.
So, violation, and the clock didn't tick one bit.
No, because if they didn't make connection with anybody. Now they got to make a basket.
There's a shot.
Oh!
Garrity hits. And it's a 3-point game. Can
Time
you
out.
Believe this?
Timeout.
41.8 seconds to go. We caught a great one at the end. The real bomb burner.
This quarter, Johnson had three threes. Garrity's got one three. Four threes in this. Oh, wait a minute. And DeVeo has a three.
There you go.
So they have five threes to make it a game.
That's 15 points right there. Imagine going to overtime.
OT. OT. OT.
You have to do a lot of explaining. You know, we get out of here at 10, 11 o'clock. Brian says we're going out for a couple of drinks. Wow, overtime.
41.8 seconds.
Overtime. My God, we'll go overtime.
Mike Troy's done a great job with his players. DeVario's trying to keep him in the game.
So Bosco now will throw it in. O'Gorman will throw it in.
Full court press by Ridgewood.
Oh. Sharma. And a foul. Sullivan. So,
two
shots. Moscow will go for two shots. They have a 10 team fouls for Ridgewood.
Two shots. Let's see who's going in on the line. Oh, the little guy.
Sharma's going to the line.
Sharma.
Two shots now.
5'9".
Misses the first one.
Well, if he makes it, 4 points. If he misses it, we're at three.
If he makes it, it's two possessions.
Plenty of time, Larry, no matter what.
It's a two-possession game now. A four-point game for Bosco. Ridgewood's got to get up and score. Even a two-point, they got to score.
Yeah, they got to score a basket. That's the key.
Jump ball, nice play in there. And the ball is going to Bosco. Jammed him.
Very nice, nice call.
Nice, very good call.
I totally agree. Still, you got plenty of time, 29.1.
They're gonna foul right away. Richard will foul right away. O'Gorman. Mauer, 25 seconds. McGlaskin.
So Mauer will go.
And then Mauer will go to the line with 22.3 seconds in a 4-point game. He makes two of them, and then it becomes a true two possessions to tie.
And it is true, because they're
if
over.
He makes two. If he doesn't make it, then you got two possessions to win.
You still got an opportunity.
23 seconds, a lot of time. Mauer will shoot. Makes the first one, makes it 55-50 with 22.3 seconds to go.
This one's big.
This will make it a 6-point game. A 6-point game, 56-50. Ridgewood quickly in.
No basket.
No basket, it was before the shot.
Oh, this is the seventh foul, so it will be 1-1.
This is definitely a 1-1. So, Carney goes to the line. If he makes the first one, he gets the second one. If he doesn't make the first one, the ball's in play.
That's correct.
6-point lead for Don Bosco.
Carney. No points for Carney at this point. Got to have ice in the veins.
Makes the first one. 56-51.
Got to make this one too. That would make it a 4-point game. No.
No
oh.
Good. Rebound up. No good. Glashing with the rebound
they
and a foul.
They had an opportunity.
Oh, yeah. Had an opportunity to put it back in, make it a 3-point game. So 12
still
seconds.
Got time. Two shots.
Then they can hold the ball out, Ridgewood, for 5 seconds. Unless they call timeout. I don't know how many timeouts he has left. We have it?
No, I don't see it on there. Well, he's got
so
two shots.
So will go to the line. It's a 5-point game now. He can make it 7. Misses the first one.
He's still keeping Ridgewood in.
We've seen some crazy games.
Missed two.
And a foul. He missed both of them and McGlashan was fouled.
They had to get the rebound. Now you make two here. It makes it almost impossible.
Yeah, I think at 56 and 2, 58, 51, with 10 seconds, that's not going to be easy. McGlashan makes this one. 57-51 with 10.2 seconds to go.
This is big one.
And this will make it a 7-point game.
And he makes it.
That's it, 58-51.
And now you got to make a quick shot.
And you don't want to foul if you're Don Bosco. Oh, it's three. Favieri hits a three. So how do you like this? It's a four-point game.
Favieri makes a three-pointer.
Sounds like LeFieri.
Yeah, Le... You know how many threes they have in this? Six threes in this quarter.
How many points do they have in this corner?
Oh, I can give you that too.
Oh, there you go. That Francola's full of stats.
25 points this quarter.
A lot of that's a lot of points. How many points does Don Bosco have in this quarter?
17.
Wow.
Oh, they come back. Yeah.
Yeah.
Richmond may have played one of the best quarters in their history. Imagine that. Six threes in a quarter. Johnson had three.
Richmond played their
Girardi hearts. Had one.
Richmond played their hearts out today.
DeFeo had one. And Favieri, my part of the Italian national anthem. What a job Troy's done. .3 seconds.
Bosco will throw it in. There'll be a foul as soon as they can get the ball in.
And it will be a two-shot foul.
Yes.
Let's see.
And let's take.
And he's the best shooter right here.
2.2 seconds. No time came off the clock.
They fouled the best shooter at foul shots.
All you got to do now, if you're Don Bosco, let them inbound the ball, let them drive the length of the court, and score the game's over.
He's got to make two foul shots here. Two foul shots is almost impossible then. Let's see. Ooh, we made it.
Dribbled it in.
Up to five. Makes this, he got two possessions.
And he got 2 seconds to do it in.
Yeah, this.
I don't think this is possible.
This is over.
Also on the floor, number four, Ryan DeFeo. Number four.
Just let them put the ball in play. And that should do it. They're going to count it. They're going to count it.
Who made that?
You know, I didn't see it. I'm sorry. 56. So it's 60 to 56. And Bosco ekes out a win. And they move on. We'll try to find out who that was. Bobby, you see the last shot? Last shot. Who made it? That was Johnson, number one.
Number one?
Number one.
He made a three-pointer, too.
A two-pointer. So 60 to 56, Don Bosco wins. They move on. So next week at 1 o'clock, we will have Ramapo versus Bergen Catholic. And at 3 o'clock, Don Bosco, St. Joe's. It should be great games next week. Sunday, come on over, 1 and 3 o'clock.
Final scores. Maroons had 13 points for Johnson, 5 points for Garrity. 3 points for DeFeo, 8 points for Osha, 5 points for Miller, 1 point for Carney, 4 for Sullivan, 15 for Favieri, total 56. And for the winners, Morair had 5, O'Gorman 8, Sharma 1, McGlashan 14, 2 for Stewart, 2 for William, and the MVP, Victor Konopka for 26.
So we thank everyone here for their help. Again, the final scores were Bergen Catholic 50, 60 to 50 over Ramsey. Rambo 78, 60 over Saddle River Day. St. Joe's 81, 67 over Teaneck. And you just saw Bosco beat Ridgewood 60 to 56. The games are set for next week, next Sunday at 1 o'clock. For everyone at WCTV, we thank you for watching. See you next Sunday from the Stratus Arena. On FDU. Good night, everybody.